you guys, welcome back to See Mindy Mom. And if you are new here, welcome to my kitchen. Today I am sharing with you some easy lunch ideas. These are things that I made at home in my own kitchen and fed my children throughout the week. But just because these are kid-friendly lunches doesn't mean that they aren't also adult-friendly. And there's probably something here for the grown-ups in your life as well. So stay tuned. All right, you guys, I've done a few of these lunch videos for you and you seem to be really enjoying them. The last one I did was from Aldi and I purchased some things that I use to pack lunches for my children for a week. My children are 11, 8, and 7, so I'm thinking about things that are not only nutritious, but things that they will enjoy eating. And I'm trying to think a little bit outside the box of just, you know, your standard lunch ideas. This past week, we were actually at home during lunchtime. It's summertime now whenever I am filming this. So I decided to take a different tack with this video concept and come up with some meals that I can make at lunchtime here at home in my own kitchen. For this challenge, I shopped at Walmart, so I'm going to show you exactly what I purchased to make these lunches. I have my receipt right here, and I spent $24.93, including tax, and that comes out to $1.66 per lunch whenever I'm making them for 3 kids across 5 days. So that's actually less than I would spend if I were buying the school lunch during the school year, and I think that's not a bad deal, especially since a lot of these are hot lunches and they're gonna be really filling. They include fruits and vegetables. So let's dive into the grocery haul. I will show you exactly what I purchased and then how I turned it into several different lunches for my kids throughout this week. Okay, here is what I ended up with from Walmart. I have one bag of fully cooked chicken nuggets, one roll of crescent rolls, one little box of cheese and pepperoni mini pizza bagels. There are 9 in this box. One cucumber, one bag of carrots, one little package. This is, let's see, 9 ounces of mesquite smoked turkey breast, 2 packages of cheese, one that's provolone and one that's extra sharp. And the interesting thing about cheese at Walmart is that this is still 8 ounces of cheese, just like in the blocks or the bags, but it's cheaper. It's 25 cents cheaper, which I know is not a lot of money, but you know, when I'm on a really tight budget here for these videos, that counts, that goes a long way. But it's 25 cents cheaper to buy it in the slice form. And I actually needed the slices for most of my meals. So I needed shredded cheese for one of them, which you'll see. And I was like, you know what? I can shred these just fine. I do have one watermelon. They were a fantastic deal. They were marked down to $2.98. I found one with a big yellow spot on it. That means it ripened on the vine. So I'm hoping it is juicy and sweet. And it was really heavy when I picked it up. So that's usually a good sign as well. One bag of frozen corn. You absolutely could do fresh or canned. I just decided to do frozen this time. One bag of broccoli florets, one little package of mashed potatoes, one can of chips. These are the Great Value brand of the Pringles, and we really like these. We think they taste, you know, they have a slightly different texture, but we actually like the texture of these a little better than Pringles, if I can say that. One package of pasta. I went for ziti, so this is a pound of pasta. And then today at my Walmart neighborhood market, the discount bakery rack was kicking, man. I mean, they had just filled it up. It was overflowing with things to choose from. And I was looking for like a little sweet treat to include with some of these meals. And I found these blueberry donut holes for just $1.27. So it's a big container of little blueberry donut holes. So that'll be a nice little sweet treat to go along with the meals. And I forgot to pick this up in my initial haul, but I was going back to Walmart later anyway. So I grabbed a can of this and I am including it in my total for these lunches. But you need some kind of pasta sauce. Here is lunch today. And it's sort of a take on like a KFC bowl, you know, with the mashed potatoes and the corn and the chicken and the cheese. I just made 6 nuggets per kid. It says a serving is 4, but my kids need at least 6. So I made 18 nuggets. I made mine in the air fryer. You could use your oven. You could warm these up in the microwave. When I make them in the air fryer for this particular kind of nugget, I cook them at 370 for 5 minutes. And then I stop it and I shake the basket. And then I cook them for another 2 minutes at 400. And they come out nice and crispy and heated through each time. I just put my bag of corn in the microwave for the amount of time that it says on the bag. And I just cooked the mashed potatoes according to the package directions. It's 2 cups of boiling water. You pour them in there, you stir them up, and voila, you have mashed potatoes. Now my son does have rice because he does not care for potatoes. He is odd. So I had some rice.
he can have that. It's leftover. But there were enough potatoes that, especially for kids, I could have easily stretched this across three kids. But my daughters will probably just eat the leftover potatoes and be very happy that Brick doesn't like them. To assemble the bowls, I just have the potatoes on the bottom. I have a little bit of corn, like maybe a couple tablespoons of corn. And then I have the chicken, which I chopped up. And then I have some shredded cheese on top. And I have shredded sliced cheese before. All I do is stack the slices on top of one another, then fold them so that they create kind of a block. That does not work with, you know, processed cheese. It has to be actual cheese, but that's how I did it. And so now we have the little KFC bowls. And I also chopped up some carrots and cucumbers, and I put three of the little blueberry donut holes on there. But I had some ranch in the fridge, so I'm gonna let them have that. The other thing that the KFC bowls usually have is barbecue sauce, but not all of my kids like it. So I'm gonna let them decide if they want some of that or not. But that's what's for lunch today. And then I have, you know, several of these items left over to use in other lunches throughout this week as well. Lunch today for the kids are these turkey and cheese crescent roll-ups with some chips and some more cucumbers and two big slices of watermelon. That whole watermelon is going to be plenty for the kids to have watermelon with four of these lunches and maybe even still have some left over. So to make the turkey and cheese roll-ups, all I do is open the crescent rolls and lay them out. And then I use just half a piece of cheese and one piece of turkey on each one, because otherwise it's kind of hard to roll them up. And since they were getting multiples, I thought that that would work out fine. After I roll all of those up, I just put them in the oven at 375. Mine took about 9 minutes and they came out great. We've done these before. We did something like this a few weeks ago and the kids really liked them. So I thought I would do it for lunch again. You could do hot dogs if you wanted instead. That would be even less expensive than the turkey would be. Mine made 8 sandwiches because the crescent rolls come 8 to a can. So I have 3 for Ruthie and 3 for Brick and 2 for McKenna because she's my lightest eater, so she probably would only eat 2 anyway. You could disperse them more evenly if you wanted to, but this is lunch for the kids today. Yummy. Lunch today is kind of like a primitive chicken parm type situation. So what I did was cook up half of my box of pasta, and I also cooked up some more chicken nuggets. I just did 18 again, 6 for each kid, and I still have some left in here. I cooked the chicken nuggets in the air fryer exactly the same way. I cooked them for about 6 minutes on 370 and then shook them and cooked them on 400 for a couple more minutes so they would get crispy on the outside. When my pasta was done, I just drained it and put it into bowls, and then I topped it with some of my pasta sauce, which I did heat up just a little bit before I put on here, and one slice of my provolone cheese. And if you want to, you can pop that into the microwave. If you want to melt the cheese a little bit, just be careful, because you probably already know that pasta sauce, tomato sauce in general, will splatter in the microwave and make a huge mess. And then I just topped it with the chicken nuggets, which I chopped up. And this is a pretty hearty meal on its own. I mean, we're probably talking about 500 calories or so right here, so it should be a pretty filling meal. I mean, this is a good portion, probably a little bit more than my kids need. Maybe I can have a little bit of it as well. So to go along with it, I just have some watermelon here to get a little bit of fruit in them. So that is lunch today. I am at the stove and I am actually prepping some lunches today of broccoli mac and cheese. And I am using a little bit of butter, flour, and milk to create a roux. And then I added the rest of my cheddar cheese, which I shredded using the same method that I talked about earlier, and some salt and pepper. Now, I know some people often get up in arms and they let me know in the comments whenever I use things to make my meals that are like, you know, pantry staples, kitchen staples, and things that I did not purchase in the grocery haul. But my thinking on that is that if you plan to start cooking, and if you are watching this video, you know, I assume that's why you're watching this video, is to get some ideas for what to cook for yourself or your family, then you're gonna have to find some wiggle room in your grocery budget to invest in some pantry staples, okay? So I used 2 tablespoons of butter and a couple tablespoons of flour. You just melt the butter, add the flour, and it forms kind of a paste, and then I poured in about 3/4 of a cup of milk, and that makes a roux, and I added some salt and pepper, and mine was a little bit thin, so I added just a little bit of water, like maybe a few tablespoons. And then I added my cheddar cheese, which I shredded using the same method. And hindsight is 2020, you guys, but I don't know why I didn't just shell out the extra 50 cents for blocks of cheese instead of the sliced cheese. I just was like, man, this is the same amount of cheese and I'm paying more for it. But anyway, you can buy whatever kind of cheese you want. But I have made my sauce now. I put the cheese in. It's there with the roux. It's probably still a tad thick, but I'm going to go ahead and add my pasta and my broccoli, which I cooked on the stove earlier. I went ahead and cooked
the broccoli with the pasta because I wanted it to be, you know, kind of mushy because I wanted it to be the same consistency as the noodles, but you could totally cook the broccoli separate and add it in at the end. It's up to you, but I'm going to go ahead and add the pasta back in and stir this all together. And then I'll show you how I'm putting lunch together for my kids with other things that we have from that grocery haul. One thought on this mac and cheese, it's looking really good right here. I'm stirring it all together, is if you don't have, you know, milk, butter, if you don't have any extras lying around, it's just bare bones right now in your kitchen, you might consider saving some of the starchy pasta water that you cooked the pasta in. And then if you just, you know, had your pasta, your shredded cheese, your pasta water, salt and pepper, just stir that all together. It'll still make, you know, a pretty tasty pasta dish. It won't be as creamy as if you go to the trouble of making the roux, but you know, that's just one option if you're in a bind, or, you know, if you're making this for kids, they might prefer just to have the pastas and then the cheese on the side and then the broccoli on the side. I know some kids really like just to have everything separate and to eat it one thing at a time. It's up to you. All right, you guys, here it is. And I went ahead and packaged it up, so to speak, in little containers because I intended for the kids to eat this tomorrow, because tomorrow is the day when we get home from gymnastics right at lunchtime. And I thought they can pop this in the microwave. They can snack on the cold stuff in the meantime while they're waiting for it to heat up. And then they won't have to wait around on me to make this lunch tomorrow. But to go along with it, we still have watermelon. That watermelon was plenty for 4 days worth of fruit for the kids. I still have turkey. And so I diced up some of the turkey, just chopped some of it up, and they can either eat it on its own or add it to their mac and cheese. And then I have three of the little blueberry donut holes in there as well for a treat. And then this mac and cheese turned out fantastic, and it yielded actually three generous servings plus an extra serving. So really four servings. I'm probably going to just eat that for lunch today. And I've already tried it and it is really delicious. I thought about adding some of this provolone that I still have left over, but it doesn't even need it. So I'll just save that for something else. And if you don't like broccoli, by all means, you can leave the broccoli out. My kids like broccoli. It's not really a hard sell for them to eat broccoli. If you wanted to get a different kind of vegetables, or you just wanted to leave the veggies out or serve them on the side, that's up to you. But this turned out really great. Super easy to make once you kind of learn how to make the roux with the butter and the flour and the milk. And then it's just stirring everything together after you cook your pasta and your broccoli. So another yummy, inexpensive lunch for the kids. And for me, yay!
Okay, so this last lunch is probably going to seem kind of odd, but let me explain my thinking with this and also what I would change, because hindsight is 20/20. So I was trying to figure out how to make some kind of pizza, like a French bread pizza or English muffin pizzas or tortilla pizzas or something like that. And I figured out as I was looking around Walmart that I couldn't make a pizza for this challenge or for this video for less money than I could just buy some kind of frozen pizza. So I found these little bagel pizzas. There are 9 in here of cheese and pepperoni mini pizza bagels. So I have 3 kids, so that's 3 a piece. And this was like $1.75 or something like that. It was really inexpensive. And for some reason, I equate serving pizza on school lunch trays with serving it with corn. I think maybe that's because that's what they served pizza with in my cafeteria growing up, or maybe what my kids always have it with. And I knew I would have some leftover corn. And so I thought, you know, I'll do the bagel bites and the corn and then other things that we have left over from the week. I knew that we would probably have a little bit of cheese or some Pringles. I knew we'd have watermelon. So I thought I would just put together like a hodgepodge type lunch. But now that I'm at the end of this challenge, I'm gonna let you know that I still have some turkey and I still have some provolone and I actually still have chicken nuggets. In fact, let me see how many I have in here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I have 11 chicken nuggets in here, so almost enough for them to have 4 a piece. So these I thought I could just roll up into like turkey and cheese pinwheels and make like little turkey and cheese pinwheels for them and then cook up the rest of these chicken nuggets, and I would not have even needed these at all. But what can I say? I couldn't really predict exactly how far this was all gonna go. So it is what it is. You can take it for what it's worth. But let me show you what's on the kids' trays today using up some of the stuff from this.
Okay, so here's the little bagel pizzas. I just threw them in the air fryer for 5 minutes. You can do them in the microwave or the toaster oven or the oven. I have some corn with just a little bit of butter and salt and pepper. I have the rest of my blueberry donut holes. I have the rest of the little cheese Pringle, the Great Value brand Pringles, and the rest of our watermelon. And like I said, I feel like this is a little low on the protein, so I'm either gonna make like some turkey and cheese pinwheels with this, or I'll probably just toss these into the air fryer and I'll put a few chicken nuggets on this plate. So it's kind of a hodgepodge lunch, but I've got some fruits and vegetables. I've got some protein. We've got some snacky stuff here. I'm just using up the rest of the stuff from this video. It won't go to waste, and the kids will actually really like this lunch. They may like this the best of them all. What can I say?
All right, you guys, that's all she wrote. or I guess that's all she filmed. I hope that that gives you some ideas or some inspiration. Let me know in the comments what you're making your kids for lunch this summer. You know, you may be sharing some ideas with somebody out there who's watching or with me, and we all need all the ideas we can get, especially for the kiddos in our household. But let's face it, some of these would work for the grownups in our life as well. Thank you so much, and I'll be sure to check in again with another video very soon.